live from the 107th floor of the Cat Country 107.3 studios, just outside beautiful Atlantic City, New Jersey. It's the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. It's your chance to fire up your brain and show South Jersey exactly who you are. Now, here are your hosts, Joe and Jahna.
Jahna, who's our contestant?
Hank from California.
Wait, not just any Hank. Actor Hank Azaria. He's famous for The Simpsons and many other things. Hank, welcome to the show.
Hi, Hank.
Thank you. Thank you for having me on. Appreciate it.
We're so excited to have you on the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. Now, we have a question for you, a quiz question.
Do you mind if I call you Joe and Jahna?
It's easier, isn't it?
We do it all the time. Both
Joe.
Of us. Yeah.
All right, no problem. Good, I'm sorry. Go ahead. What do you got?
Love that he asked that because right. I do that to you so much.
Before we get to the actual quiz question, an actual honest question, kind of a test question. Of all the roles that you've done, acting, movie, TV, behind the scenes, voice, who's your favorite character you've ever played?
Ooh.
My favorite of all time is Mo the bartender on The Simpsons. Just because I used to actually bartend, so I kind of feel like if I didn't become Mo the bartender, I would have remained Hank the bartender.
That's good.
Almost
good.
Done.
But the one that people talk to me about the most is Agador Spartacus from The Birdcage. He's the one that people come up to me the most about.
That's so good. That's awesome.
It's an imitation of my grandmother. There's a fun fact for you.
That's awesome.
I must talk like this.
All right. Let's get to the actual quiz question. Are you ready, Hank Azaria?
I guess. All right. Let's go, Joe.
Here's the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge question. In 20 seconds, Hank, give us the voices of four of your favorite Simpson characters, all expressing their love and adoration for Jahna.
Ooh.
Go.
Well, you heard from Mo. He loves girls with soft J's names there. Comic book guy, he would say best name ever. Professor Frank, of course, with a love the sound of a jiving Jay. And let's go with Cletus. Cletus can't pronounce Jahna. I'm gonna call you Johnny.
That works.
That works. Nailed it.
Hank Azaria, you're a winner of the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge.
It's lucky I came along because anybody else probably wouldn't have done too well at that.
Right.
Probably not.
Jahna, tell Hank what he's won.
Absolutely nothing but my heart forever and ever, that's for sure.
Well, that's a lot. That's seriously a lot. I'm actually going to cash it in.
Ooh.
Hank, we're going to let you grab breakfast and we'll talk to you again a little bit later on this morning on Cat Country.
All right, then.
This has been the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge from Cat Country 107.3.
Waking up with Joe and Jahna, Cat Country 107.3.
Cat Country 107.3 mornings with Joe and Jahna, Post Malone, and Blake Shelton, and Pour Me a Drink. A big thanks to Hank Azaria, our new best friend. You love him from The Simpsons, for being our guest on our Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. We're actually going to check back in with Hank between 8 and 8:30, he's got a project going on in our area that we're going to talk about. So that'll be with Hank Azaria after 8 o'clock this morning. We got a couple chances for you to win Barefoot Country Music Fest passes before they go on sale. First chance is at 6:20. And today, Friday the 27th of September, Love Note Day. When was the last time you left somebody a love note?
Oh, my gosh.
8th grade?
Maybe.
Chocolate Milk Day. Jahna, it says you're today's morning show host day.
That's us.
I don't know what we get.
Absolutely nothing.
We'll be looking in the mail for something.
Yeah.
It's also hug a veggie. Morning, we're Joe and Jahna. Here are three things you need to know this morning. If there was any doubt, Ocean City is going to remain a dry town.
Had some of the best times. Never.
The city council unanimously approved a new resolution supporting the existing prohibition. At the same time, council approved a resolution formally opposing the treatment of sewage from Upper Township at the plant at 45th Street in Ocean City. So says Ocean City, we don't want your booze and we don't want your blank.
Right. Emergency workers from New Jersey have been deployed to the areas hit by Hurricane Helene.
The calm within the storm.
The Category 4 storm made landfall about 45 miles southeast of Tallahassee late last night. New Jersey Task Force 1 was deployed Wednesday night. They traveled to North Carolina, where a state of emergency is in effect. The task force is prepared to stay in North Carolina for 2 weeks, but could stay longer if needed.
Tickets for next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest on the beach in Wildwood go on sale today. Next year will mark the fifth year for the four-day event. Last year's festival sold out.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it will be a mostly cloudy day. Scattered rain likely with a high of 73.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com/storm prep.
And we're talking about Carrie Underwood. Unless you've been living under a rock, then you know she's headed back to where it all began. She just landed a gig as a judge on American Idol. But according to a new report, she's going to be earning significantly less than her predecessor, Katy Perry. No bueno in my book. Okay. Absolutely not. But apparently the only reason that Perry got paid that much was because of how much time she wound up having to dedicate to the show itself. I don't think Carrie... I don't want you to think that Carrie's getting chump change, though. Sources say it's somewhere around $12 million compared to Katy Perry's $25 million per season. All those details are up now at catcountry1073.com. Jason Aldean's wife, Brittany, she's giving everyone a look behind the scenes of Jason's new music video for his song, Whiskey Drink. She was his stylist on the shoot, so she kind of walked fans through how they decided what he would wear and the minimal makeup that Jason gets before the shoot begins. He didn't even put up a fight because he said he wanted to look his best. We've got the video up for you right now on the Cat Country 107.3 app.
107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Everything is going wrong today, Jahna. I don't know what to do.
It's Friday. It's okay. It's Friday.
We're going to give away tickets before they go on sale to the Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood next summer. We don't know who the artists are yet. They haven't been announced. But tickets are going on sale today. I would get tickets early. Their lowest prices are available today, starting at 10. They'll never be lower.
Ever. And everybody waits, and then you get upset, and
I'm
telling you.
Last year was sold out.
Yep.
All right, we're going to play a game called Answer Wrong and Win. We're playing now, and then again at 7:20. Let's go to the phones. Cat Country, your caller number 7.
Awesome.
Who's this?
This is Joe.
Hey, Joe.
Where are you from?
I am from Vendor.
All right, Joe, we're going to try to win you the first 4-day passes to next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest. We're going to be playing our game called Answer Wrong and Win. Do you need the rules?
Sure.
Okay, I'm going to ask you questions. You need to answer wrong and win.
That's all it is.
Okay, cool.
All right, Joe, here we go. Question number 1. How many items are there in a dozen?
3.
Very good. Number 2. What is the traditional color worn by a bride on her wedding day?
Purple.
One more question, Joe. How many leftovers are currently in the Cat Country Commissary refrigerator?
3,000.
That's very low. It's actually 86,000 and half of them are fish.
But
Joe, you're a winner! Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Joke of the Morning. This happens every weekday morning at this time from Abseekin. Gary has sent us today's joke.
Gary, thank you.
Why is it when I donate a kidney, I'm a hero? But when I donate 6 kidneys, the police have all these questions.
I mean, little different. Little different.
And when I bring in my blood donations in buckets, it's Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. The winning has already begun. Joe from Ventnor won our first pair of 4-day passes to next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest before they go on sale. Congratulations to Joe. We're going to give you another chance to win Barefoot tickets coming up at 7:20 this morning. Oh, and at 8:20, how about some money? Like $30,000.
30K.
Cash Cow continues today at 8:20. Your first of 10 chances to win free money on Cat Country 107.3. Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Dumb Story of the Morning.
Where are we going?
Thailand. A 36-year-old man has been arrested for performing penile enlargement procedures for 2 decades without a medical license. You heard me right. I'm not going to repeat it.
So, all right, continue.
Despite only having a 9th grade education, Kitty Corn Sangre operated on patients inside his townhouse. He advertised his penile enlargement procedures on social media, conducting surgeries on 2 to 3 patients each month. Sangri was self-taught in implants since age 14.
Whoa!
Well, the other kids are out playing soccer. He's messing with, you know. He was reported by a patient who suffered severe infections.
Yeah, I bet you did.
After an undercover sting operation, authorities arrested Sangri, who admitted to performing procedures for 20 years.
Ow. Just ow and no. Ow, no, thank you.
I don't know. I think I'll go to this guy. He's on Facebook. Good morning. We're Joe and Jahna. Here are three things you need to know this morning. If there was any doubt, Ocean City is going to remain a dry town.
At some of the best times, you'll never remember with me. Alcohol.
The city council unanimously approved a new resolution supporting the existing prohibition. At the same time, council approved a resolution formally opposing the treatment of sewage from Upper Township at the plant at 45th Street in Ocean City. So says Ocean City, we don't want your booze and we don't want your blank.
Right, right. Emergency workers from New Jersey have been deployed to the areas hit by Hurricane Helene. Category 4 storm made landfall about 45 miles southeast of Tallahassee late last night. New Jersey Task Force 1 was deployed Wednesday night. They traveled to North Carolina, where a state of emergency is in effect. The task force is prepared to stay in North Carolina for 2 weeks, but could stay longer if needed.
Tickets for next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest on the beach in Wildwood go on sale today. Next year will mark the fifth year for the four-day event. Last year's festival sold out.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it will be a mostly cloudy day. Scattered rain likely with a high of 73.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com. Barefoot Country Music Fest passes for you to win in about 5. Right now, Cat Country Morning birthday shout-outs. We got a big, long list today.
Yes, we do. First up, we have to shout out a very special birthday tomorrow morning. He is going to be blank, blank years young tomorrow. Our very own Joe Kelly, ladies and gentlemen.
That would be
Joe Kelly. He's turning blank, blank years young tomorrow.
Blank, blank.
Happy birthday, Joseph.
All right.
No. We also have Karen Fairchild from Little Big Town tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Did you know that you guys are birthday twins?
We have the same birthday, yes.
Yes. Okay, so you did know that. Anyway, she's going to be 55 tomorrow, so happy birthday.
Happy birthday today. Tina Glassford of Belle Plaine, she's 64. Chris Labs of Estelle Manor, 77. Mandy Sadean of Cedarville celebrates today.
Ooh.
Dave Borowitz of Rio Grande is 40. Terry Lee McGowan of Galloway has a birthday today. Nicole Leah of Cape May Courthouse has a birthday. Happy birthday to Jim Solomon of Mullica Hill, who's 37.
Happy birthday.
Vera Arthur of Tom's River has a birthday. Scott Gatto is 40. Scott is from Egg Harbor Township. Valerie Burnside of Atlantic City is 39. Kim Schultz of Millville is 53 today. Nicole Sullivy of Barnegat is 38. Happy birthday, Lou Joseph Jr. Lou is 40. Jamie Berry of Port Norris has a birthday today. Celebrating tomorrow with me, Barbara Harris of Bridgeton.
All right,
happy birthday, Barbara. Also tomorrow, Amy Robbins of Millville will be 54. And Sunday, my good friend Joanne Wayand of Cape May Courthouse will be 63. Happy birthday, Joanne.
Woo, Joanne.
We missed you. Happy one to you as well. The recipient of our Cat Country Big Birthday shout out, Valerie Burnside of Atlantic City. It's Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. So later today, 10 o'clock, tickets go on sale for next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood. We don't know any of the artists yet. They have not been announced. Well, some of us might know some of the artists, but they have not been announced yet. So you're kind of flying blind here. I can tell you it is going to be good. It's going to be very good.
It's going to be so good.
Tickets, when they go on sale today, will be at the lowest prices they will be all year. And last year they sold out. So next year is going to sell out.
Yeah. Easily.
Especially when they start announcing the artists.
Easily.
But you don't have to buy tickets. You can win them right now here on Cat Country 107.3, your favorite radio station in Atlantic City and South Jersey. We're going to play our game called Answer Wrong and Win. If you can successfully navigate three questions and answer wrong and win, we're going to give you two, not just one, but two four-day passes to next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood.
Nice.
Imagine that.
Nice.
Two passes worth how much? How many hundreds of dollars?
Multiple.
And you won't have to worry about it?
Right.
If you don't want to go, maybe it's a great Christmas present. Or maybe it is a great Christmas present for your spouse.
Or yeah.
Hey, we're going to Barefoot.
Merry Christmas.
Got it taken care of. We're going to take caller 7 right now at 609-383-107. Joe and Jahna. He was so great at the Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood last summer.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
We're already looking to next summer, Barefoot. Next September on the beach in Wildwood. 4 big days of country music. Some of country music's biggest stars. I know who the 4 headliners are, and I feel comfortable saying country music's biggest stars. I really do.
Well, and you, I mean, you said to me earlier today, you were like, Jahna, next year you're going to have to prepare yourself because I'm going to be staying all night, which is great.
All right, we're giving away two four-day passes right now to caller number 7. We're going to play our game called Answer Wrong and Win. Let's go to the phones. Hi, Cat Country, you are caller 7. Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Don't whisper. We can't hear you when you whisper.
I'm not whispering.
You know you're caller 7, right?
What's your name?
Yes, Tina.
Tina.
Tina, where are you from?
Sri Lanka, Hamilton.
All right.
Tina, would you like to go to the Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood next summer?
Yes, I would. I saw you there last year.
Oh, awesome.
All right. Who would you like to see at Barefoot, by the way? If you had a choice.
Keith Urban again.
Oh, he was good.
I'll give you that.
All right.
Yeah.
Tina, we're going to play a game called Answer Wrong and Win. Do you need the rules or do you understand?
I understand.
All right. There's a lot of pressure to answer wrong because you want to answer right. So let's see how you do, Tina.
So don't answer right, Tina.
Question number 1. Name a small furry animal associated with Easter.
A cat.
Very good.
Good. There you go.
What is the 3rd letter of the alphabet?
Z.
Yeah.
How many bases are there on a baseball field?
10.
Tina, you're going to the Barefoot Country Music Fest in Wildwood. Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome to the show our little friend.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Phil.
Hi, Phil.
Hello, Phil.
Da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, I'm sorry. I got caught in the melody. Hi, Miss Jahna and Mr. Kelly. How are you?
We're great.
Lovely.
Yourself?
It's going to rain, so yeah, my little body is hurt right now.
Yeah.
Sorry. Well, we've gathered you together today. Play a game called Strip Club or Daycare. Are you in?
Not that there's anything wrong with that on a Friday.
Correct.
All right, here we go. You ready, Jahna?
I'm always ready.
All right, number 1, the Glass Slipper in Boston, Massachusetts. Is that a strip club or a daycare? The Glass Slipper, Boston, Massachusetts.
Okay.
Jahna's locked in her answer. What do you think, Phil?
Strip club, definitely, Joseph.
Yeah, strip club.
Jahna? All right, you're both correct.
It is
a strip club. Now we're going to go to Charleston, South Carolina. The place is called The Glass Slipper.
Oh, my God.
The Glass Slipper in Charleston, South Carolina. It's not Glass Slipper 2. It's just The Glass Slipper. Again, Charleston, South Carolina. Strip club or daycare.
Okay.
Bill?
Same spelling?
Yes.
Oh, of course. We're going to say strip club still.
I'm going to say daycare.
It's a strip club.
Oh, man.
We fooled you.
Yeah.
Okay, 1-0 or 2-1 lead. All right, number 3, Forest Hills, Texas, All-Stars. All-Stars in Forest Hills, Texas, strip club or daycare? All right, Bill, what do you think?
We're going to go daycare in the last one, Joseph.
Jahna, what do you think?
Daycare.
It is a daycare, but by a score of 3-2, this week's big winner is Little Phil.
Phil,
congratulations.
What?
Thank you for the lovely description.
Champ.
Well, we wanted to make sure people knew which one we're talking about.
You're a champion. Oh.
Any big plans for the weekend, Phil?
No, I'm trying to get over this cloud that you've put over me. Thank you.
I'm here with us this morning. Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. We want to talk about a great moment in history.
What, you're talking about because it's your birthday tomorrow?
No.
Oh.
That's good, but no. Back in 1820, a guy saved the Jersey tomato. In the early 1800s and before, no one ate tomatoes, Jahna, because everyone thought they were poisonous.
Really?
Yes. There wasn't even an internet to spread this, but somebody said, tomatoes are poisonous, don't ever eat those things. And a guy by the name of Colonel Robert Gibson Johnson, he was a politician, he was in the whatever service there was at the time.
Yeah.
He was a horticulturist.
He
stood on the steps of the courthouse in Salem County, New Jersey. He hired a band to come out and play Hundreds of people showed up, and in front of everyone, he ate a tomato.
And people, didn't die.
People were thinking that he was going to die. They came out to watch him die.
That's crazy.
And he lived.
People just came out to see. It's like going to watch somebody walk into the guillotine.
Something.
That's so
he's
weird.
Like, and he had the band like, and he took a bite of the tomato and he lived.
He should have took the act on tour and made money. Shocked everyone.
And because of him, we have the BLT, not the BL.
You're right.
So
we owe him our lives.
We have more details on the man who saved the Jersey tomato. Check it out, catcountry1073.com, the catcountry 107.3. Good morning, we're Joe and Jahna. Here are three things you need to know this morning. If there was any doubt, Ocean City is going to remain a dry town.
Had some of the best times, never remember with me. Alcohol.
The city council unanimously approved a new resolution supporting the existing prohibition. At the same time, council approved a resolution formally opposing the treatment of sewage from Upper Township at the plant at 45th Street in Ocean City. So says Ocean City, we don't want your booze and we don't want your blank.
Right. Emergency workers from New Jersey have been deployed to the areas hit by Hurricane Helene. The Category 4 storm made landfall about 45 miles southeast of Tallahassee late last night. New Jersey Task Force 1 was deployed Wednesday night. They traveled to North Carolina, where a state of emergency is in effect. The task force is prepared to stay in North Carolina for 2 weeks, but could stay longer if needed.
Tickets for next summer's Barefoot Country Music Fest on the beach in Wildwood go on sale today. Next year will mark the fifth year for the four-day event. Last year's festival sold out.
And your South Jersey weather for today, it will be a mostly cloudy day. Scattered rain likely with a high of 73.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com/storm prep. Backcountry 107.3 mornings with Joe and Jahna. Cash cow in 5 minutes right now, though, my favorite tweets from the last 24 hours.
All right, here we go.
There are five of them. Number one, once a reporter gets hit by a piece of roof and washed out to sea, maybe then the Weather Channel will stop having them report from the inside of hurricane.
I always feel so bad too, because like they look like they're holding on for dear life. Like poor Al Roker sometimes just like gripping onto a pole. It's awful.
Number two, peanut M&Ms are healthier than plain M&Ms because they've got vegetables in them or something.
Yeah. Well, they got protein.
Number three, when I was a kid, nearly every girl in my class had feathered hair and thought she was Farrah Fawcett Minor.
Farrah Fawcett Majors. Yeah.
But yeah, that's my childhood. Every girl.
Not mine.
Number four, me, doing homework at age 15. When am I ever going to need to find the coordinates of two intersecting points on a graph in real life?
For real.
40 years later, my 15-year-old doing homework. Can you help me with finding the coordinates of two intersecting points on a graph? Son of a bitch.
Yep.
Number five, we're Joe and Jahna. These are my favorite tweets. Last one.
Funny.
Number five, that's all we ever needed it for. Adulting is great if all you want to do is pay bills and do laundry and figure out what's for dinner. Our friend, funny man, actor, you know him on The Simpsons, Hank Azaria. He'll be back joining us on the show here in just a few minutes. But right now, it's time. It is time for Cash Cow on Cat Country 107.3.
Trying to get you in your weekend right, you know what I mean?
First of 10 chances to play today. You can play 20 minutes past every hour, or about 20 minutes past every hour. Every hour from now until 5:20 p.m. today. So while you work, listen and grab codes every hour. When you get a code, go to the Cat Country 107.3 app. Pop the button that says win $30,000 cash and type in the code. And your first code of the day is 487.
487. That's the code you need. 487. Click on the win $30,000 button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. 487. That's what you're going to type in. And then we'll have another chance for you at $30,000 coming up at 9:20.